They could be really, really small, like so small that we couldn't even see them.
Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could zip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could zip right by. Tiny spaceships from far away. Getting eaten by hungry bats or snatched up by a frog's long tongue, the tiny spaceman would be long gone. Lost on a mission is one of the few to study the giants of planet blue. That's me and you. You wanna know why? 'Cause we are the aliens in their eyes. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could slip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could slip right by. They're from a planet that's cold and gray, in a universe light years away. And even though it sounds like it's very far, what if it's the universe next to ours that makes us neighbors with a space-time fence? If the universe begins right where ours ends, a trillion galaxies and trillions of stars, and somehow they found their way to ours. And tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could slip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could slip right by. Tiny spaceships. Tiny spaceships. Tiny spaceships. Tiny spaceships.